not a formal, a legal formalist. So I don't think, I'm quite the opposite. So I don't think that, you know, law has a kind of inherent meanings. Words don't have inherent meanings. It's a struggle over the meaning. So in that sense, you can see, for example, that the United States, it is well known that when after decisions such as Brown versus Board of Education or Roe versus Wade, which were relatively progressive or quite progressive, conservative movements started to use law in order to, and sometimes very similar concept in order to push their agenda. So, for example, the struggle over abortion can be framed in very similar issues of, I mean, it's different rights sometimes, sometimes it's the same right. So in that sense, I think that, you know, it's quite logical. I mean, a lot of international law has been relatively more formalistic than other legal discourses for, we can talk about what's the reason behind it, but I just think, you know, you have, if I mean, probably you're gonna, if you are, let's say, a social activist, and you think about things strategically, say, well, should I use the courts? Should I use the courts to get evidence? Should I use the courts strategically to lose in my fight, but have movements mobilize? Should I not use the law? That's one of the questions I wanted to ask Amanda. I mean, there are alternatives. You can use guerrilla, for example, no? I mean, there are other alternatives to using law, and if it's returned to my question, because I see if you go to court and you don't get enough remedies, then all your energy is going to court instead of going to other places. So I really think that it really depends. In the case of the Bedouin, I just think that they don't have a lot of evidence. I mean, maybe they use force. I mean, it might come to that. That might be.